Let's look at this question from CAT 2018 DIR section of slot 2. Each of the 23 boxes in the picture below represents a product manufactured by one of the following three companies, Alpha, Bravo and Charlie. The area of a box is proportional to the revenue from the corresponding product, while its center represents the product popularity and market potential scores of the product out of 20. The shadings of some of the boxes have got erased. Okay, then you have this graph. Okay, so looking at this graph, some of the things that you can infer are alpha. So this is alpha, 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 and this is alpha. Okay, Bravo. So this is Bravo, this is Bravo, blah blah. I don't know why I'm doing this, but C and C, these two are Charlie, and these are unknown. We'll take care of it later. You have this graph. The companies classified the products into four categories based on a combination of scores out of 20 on the two parameters, product popularity and market potential as given below. Okay, so product popularity is the x-axis, market potential is the y-axis. From the graph we can see that product popularity score is also greater than 10 and market potential score is also greater than 10, then you are labeled promising. Okay, so I'm trying to draw a line to represent which zone they are talking of. It will look something like this. So effectively this region is promising. I'm writing it PP. And if product popularity score is greater than 10 but market potential score is less than 10, so this quadrant, this fourth quadrant of the graph we are talking of, it is blockbuster. So this is blockbuster. The outfill is product popularity score is less than 10 and market potential score is greater than 10. So this is doubtful. The last one is no hope. Less than 10, less than 10. So this is no hope. See, I am not saying that in the exam you would have the opportunity of drawing lines like this. But what you can do is, mentally when you look at this, hopefully you can see that the graph that you're dealing with is getting divided into four zones, and from there on you have to proceed. Okay, we have been able to divide it into four segments with these four names. Let's see what extra thing we can do here. Okay, so let me write PP here, let me write BB here, let me BB, not BD, BB. I get doubtful here and no hope here. Now simply record this. Alpha should be alpha, but okay, doesn't make much of a difference. Whatever products you have, record them under whichever category they come in. Promising, all three are unknown, and we know the revenue is denoted by their size. So the unknown things are 2, 9 and 3. Let it be that way. 2, 9 and 3. We don't know what comes in alpha, what comes in bra. For blockbuster, this bottom quadrant, I know alpha. You have a 3 here and you have a 6 here. This can be recorded. For Bravo, you again have a 6. Guaranteed. For Charlie, you have a 2 and you have a 6. And for unknown, you have a 4 and you have a 9. Simple estimation. Don't bother too much about measuring and recording. This would be good enough for you to record. Let's get to doubtful. Alpha here is 1 and 4. 1 and 4. Beta here is 2. Sorry, 2. Yes, 2. And 6. Okay. And unknown is 1, 6 and 9. 1, 6 and 9. Okay. Let's look at no hopers. No hopers. We have unknown 1, 1, 3. Recording unknowns first. 1, 1, 3. Alpha here is 2 and 4. 2 and 4. And beta, Bravo here. Not beta. Bravo here is 4. Okay. So I've managed to reach this. I can also reach the total for promising. Total for promising will be 9 plus 3 plus 2. It should be 14.
Total for blockbuster is 9 plus 4 is 13, 13 plus 8 is 21, 21 plus 6 is 27, 27 plus 9 is 36, so this should be 36. Here I will get 16 plus 8, 24, 24 plus 5, 29, and here I will get 3 plus 1 plus 1, 5, 5 plus 4, 9, 9 plus 6, 15. So I have total revenue of all the products that are mentioned here. I can also get that. In the next phase, I am breaking one of my own rules. I have recorded this values, these values that I have managed to reach here. On the next page, pre-written them, because otherwise it became too difficult, too messy in a single graph, in a single diagram. I hope you don't mind. I have written down the values here. Let's go through the individual instructions and see what all we've got. Alpha and Bravo have the same number of products in the blockbuster category. Okay. See, Alpha already has 2, Bravo has 1, and there are 2 unknowns here. There are 2 unknowns here. So can I say if Alpha and Bravo have equal number of things? If Alpha got 1 more, Bravo will not be able to catch up. So Alpha is not getting any more, Bravo is getting 1 more, and Charlie is getting 1 more. Out of these 2, 4 and 9s, 1 will come here, 1 will come here. Okay, taking care of the first point. The second point is Charlie had more products than Bravo but fewer products than Alpha in No Hope category. Okay, Charlie had more than Bravo but fewer than Alpha. Now look at No Hope, how many products are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Only 6 products are there. If Charlie is more than Bravo and less than Alpha, the only way it can be achieved is if Bravo has 1, Charlie has 2 and Alpha has 3. So there will be 1 here, there will be 2 here. Which values I don't know, but this will be the distribution. Okay, let's look at the third point. Each company had an equal number of products in the promising category. Promising category, everybody is blank, and there are 3 products, so blank, blank, and blank. Okay, Charlie did not have any product in the doubtful category. Okay, so there is nothing here. While Alpha had 1 more product than Bravo in this category. In the doubtful category, Alpha had 1 more product than Bravo. So you would have blank and blank. You would have blank. See, total products are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 4 have to go here, 3 have to go here. Done. Let's look at the fifth point. Bravo had a higher revenue than Alpha from products in the doubtful category. In the doubtful category, the total product is 29. Bravo is supposed to have a higher revenue than Alpha, so Bravo needs to have at least 15 here. So if I give 2, 6 and 1 more, if I give 1, it will not reach 15. If I give 6, it will reach 14 but not 15. So I can only proceed with giving it 9, and thereby I will have 1 and 6 left here, and then this is done, entirely done, already accounted for. Okay, let's look at point 6. Charlie had a higher revenue than Bravo from products in the blockbuster category. If Charlie had a higher revenue than Bravo from the products in blockbuster category, there are just 2 possibilities. Either you can give 4 here or 9. If I give 9 here, 6 plus 9 is 15. 2 plus 6 plus 4 is 12. Charlie would be lower, so I cannot give 9 here. I will necessarily give 4. I will necessarily give 9 here. And this is also taken care of. Wonderful. Let's go to question numbers. Point 7. Bravo and Charlie had the same revenue for products in No Hope category. Bravo has a revenue of 4 in No Hope. Charlie is also supposed to get 4. So it will be 1 here and 3 here. Those are the only possibilities. By extension, there will be 1 here. So brilliant. We have also distributed this now. Okay. The last point is Alpha and Charlie had the same total revenue considering all products. Okay, currently what is the total for Alpha? 3 plus 6, 9. 1 plus 4 plus 6, so this is 12. And this is 7. So currently the product that I am getting is 28. What is it that I am getting for Charlie? 9 plus 2 plus 6, 17. 17 plus 4, I am getting 21. Let me also write it down. Maybe I need it later. So I get 17 here. I get 4 here. Okay. Currently they differ by 7. Currently they differ by 7. I need to make them equal. So I need to give something to Charlie that is 7 more than that what alpha receives. I need a gap of 7 and it can be attained by 2 and 9. So Charlie receives 9 here, alpha receives 2 here, and if alpha receives 2 here, can I say the total here will be 30? The total here will be 30. Bravo will correspondingly receive 3 and the total here will now be 34. Let me also check. We'll eliminate any errors if I have made it. I get 4 here. 2 plus 6 plus 9 is 17. I get 10 here and I get 3 here. Yes, I'm getting a total of 34. Let me also write 9 here and 2 here. Okay. So I have all this data available. This unknown has also been allocated. Everything is known to me. Let's get to individual questions. Considering all companies' products, which product category had the highest revenue? Highest revenue was highest for Blockbuster. So the answer is option 4, Blockbuster. Which of the following is the current sequence of number of products in of Bravo had in No Hope, Doubtful, Promising and Blockbuster? Pay attention, the order is important. So No Hope for Bravo has 1. So the first thing has to be 1, so these two options are gone. Now I'll simply see the last one because they are the only different. Blockbuster, how many does Bravo have? Blockbuster, they have 2. So this option is also gone. So this will be the answer. Which of the following statements is not correct? Okay. Bravo's revenue from Blockbuster products was greater than Alpha's revenue from Doubtful products. Bravo's Blockbuster, Alpha, Doubtful. Not correct. Yes, this statement is not correct. Bravo's revenue from Blockbuster products is only 10. Alpha's revenue from Doubtful products is 12. So this is not correct. But for the peace of our mind, we'll check the other ones as well. The total revenue from No Hope products was less than the total revenue from Doubtful products. No Hope less than Doubtful. Yes, this is true. So this will not be the answer. Bravo and Charlie had the same revenue from No Hope products. Bravo and Charlie had the same revenue from the No Hope category. If you notice, this is same as point number 7. So this is definitely not the answer. Fourth one, Alpha's revenue from Blockbuster products was same as Charlie's revenue from Promising products. Alpha's from Blockbuster is 9. Charlie from Promising, yes, 9 and 9, they are same. So this will also not be the answer. Now I have more confidence. Option 1 is correct. Now, last question, question number 4. If the smallest box on the grid is equivalent to revenue of rupees 1 crore, then what approximately was the total revenue of Bravo in rupees crore? See, when we are recording the data here, one unit box was taken as one unit only. So the revenue for Bravo is 34 units, and we've been told the smallest box on the grid is equivalent to 1 crore. So revenue will be 34 crore. And therefore, the answer to question number 4 will be option 4, 34. This question is relatively easier than most people make it out to be. Just that in the first go, what you have to do is whatever is present in this graph, just record it in a table format. Once you do that, these statements are very simple to interpret. These statements make our life extremely easy. Then you can reach your answer in reasonably less time.